This week, I'm going to show you the powerful features of Apple Calendar. Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pauline and this week it's all about Apple Calendar and the powerful features that Apple Calendar actually has. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because if you search calendar on YouTube or anywhere, you're going to find a lot of videos on Google Calendar. And yet, I know Google Calendar is a very powerful calendar, but did you know that Apple Calendar is almost as powerful as Google Calendar? Probably not. Now, there are a few features that Google Calendar has that Apple Calendar doesn't have. That's simply because we're in the Apple ecosystem. But one of the things that I love about Apple Calendar is it's so solid and so dependable. And the features that pretty much we all use and love about Google Calendar are in Apple Calendar. You just got to be able to find them, and I'm going to show you where they are today. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you get any value from this video whatsoever, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe for all the latest tips, tricks, and news on Apple's productivity system. Oh, and one point before we go into Apple Calendar is, before anyone asks, because everyone seems to ask this question, can you link Apple Calendar to Apple Reminders? The answer is no, you cannot do that. I'm sorry, it's not available yet. Maybe it will come in the future, maybe not, but right now you cannot link your Reminders app to your calendar app. I just want to clear that up before we move on. Okay, let me now take you into my Apple Calendar and show you the powerful features that Apple Calendar has. Okay, so here is my regular Apple Calendar set up on my computer. This is just a demo account. What I want to do is I want to show you some of the things that you can actually do with Apple Calendar. Now, on the internet, there's a lot of stuff on to do with Google Calendar, but I haven't been able to find a great deal of information about what you can do with Apple Calendar, and actually it's quite powerful. Now, I'm showing you this on my laptop simply because you have greater flexibility to organize on your laptop. Now, in theory, all of this is able to do on your iOS device, but it's just a little bit more fiddly. So I thought I would show you the basics on my laptop, which is much easier, and you can then try this on your own iOS devices if you don't have a laptop. So let's just create a new event. So this, we'll just call this a new event. And first of all, you can add the location. Now, I live in South Korea, so we'll do Seoul. If I type in Seoul, it gives me all sorts of different places. So if the more accurate you are with address, you can actually add the address. Now, what this does is essentially this will then add a map to the actual event, which is great if you're actually traveling somewhere. So the more specific you are with the address, it will add a map to the event. As we go down, you can add all sorts of different things. So you can create an all-day event if you wish, but this is just a one-hour appointment, so it's between 10 a.m. and 11 a.m. And you can set the time zone. So if you're going to be traveling to, say, Berlin, or you're traveling to Bangkok, or you're traveling to Chicago, you can actually set the time. Now, let's say this could be a repeating event I do every Monday morning at 10 to 11. I can set that every day, week, month, year, or I can customize it to create whatever days I want, which is really cool if you wish to do that. You can add the travel time, which I actually love, and I do use this in my main calendar. So I usually add the travel time, so it adds the travel time right there. So let's just, I can't move this, I don't think, no, because this is actually a subscribed account just for saving. But if I just drag this down a little bit, you can actually see that I've got the travel time now in there, which is really, really cool. You can add invitees, so you can actually invite people. So I'm going to add in my regular email address there. So I can add that, I can add a number of others, and I can then send that. And what you'll see is you get this little icon with a question mark. Now, when I receive that in my own account, this will then invite me to actually accept the invitation. Once I accept the invitation, that question mark changes to a tick, a check mark. And I can also add a lot of notes. So I can add notes related to the event. I can actually add my website address, so www.carlpauline.com. And so that's there, so it becomes a clickable link. I can also add attachments. And from my desktop, let's say I select this PDF, so we're going to add that, I can add the attachment. So the attachment is there as well. And this is openable by all the invitees. So let's say, for example, that you've got an agenda, you can add the agenda attachment to that. And as soon as you hit update, that is going to send. Now you get these little icons here. So this tells you that there is something attached to it. And likewise, if you are the invited person, you will also see that attachment. So there's actually a lot of things that you can do. One of the things that I do a lot in my particular calendar is, let's take this one for example, I have the actual address here. So you can see as what happens, the map comes up, which is great. And I can actually here go into this, so you double tap on that, or you just tap on that, and I can repeat this every week. Now what it will do is it'll ask, when do you want to end the repeat? So you can end a repeat on a specific day. So let's say I'm gonna end that in June, or let's say end of May. So that's now gonna run till the end of May, which is really good. And I can also change that. I can do that after, and then I can have 16 times or 10 times or whatever. So you've got quite a bit of flexibility there of what you can actually do with the actual task itself. So it's Apple Calendar is a lot more powerful than people generally think. I can also change the standard time here. So one of the things that I've done is, obviously I originally from the United Kingdom, so I can change the time zone here, and now it changes the times down here. So I can see that if I was teaching in the UK, you know, my time zone would be quite horrendous, actually, like teaching 1-to-1 at 3 o'clock in the morning, not my idea of fun. So I can switch that there. And of course, you can add other ones right here by clicking on that, and then you can add in other ones if you wish. So there's a lot of things that you can do within your Apple Calendar, and it's a really powerful tool when you start to use it more effectively, more than just adding regular dates. I mean, all these at the moment, these are subscribed calendars. I've actually scribed this from a Google Calendar, but that was just to save time putting this stuff in. This is just my demo account, but you can do all sorts of things. Now let's say this is a repeating task now, and let's say I want to delete this task. So if I hit delete, it's now going to ask me, do I want to delete only this event, which means it will only delete this one, delete them all, which would mean all 16 future events, or I can just cancel that. So if I just delete this, only this event, you'll see that it's still there for next week, the following week. I'm only deleting that one account. So these are the sort of things that you can do. They are really, really useful. And when you start to really use the power of Apple's calendar, it is maybe not quite on a par with Google Calendar, but it certainly does give you a lot of options. And one of the things that I can do is I can actually add into the link here, I can add my Zoom account. So for example, I have in my text expander, I'm going to add a note here. I don't know if this is going to work, but I can type it. Oh yes, I can actually add a Zoom link to here, so that if I update that, that's still going to update to all participants in the meeting. So if I've set up a meeting, I can actually use that link to my to all participants, so they know that they can join the meeting from there. So there you go. There's just a quick overview of some of the powerful features that Apple Calendar has. Now you can do this on an iOS device. As I say, I've only showed this on the desktop because it's much easier to show on a screen like this. But if you play around with the iOS devices, you will have all the same feature set. It is a very powerful calendar application. And of course, you do have access to this through iCloud.com. Hopefully you found this interesting, and hopefully you've got some ideas about how you can get the best out of Apple Calendar. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing, and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders, and calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.